If new contacts are not getting emails, your company is going to go up in flames. If potential new customers are filling out opt-in forms or to book services, or heck, even just to join your email list, and they're not getting an immediate email, that is a recipe for disaster. But wait, I rebuilt an automation. Then why isn't it working? Why aren't people getting my lead magnets? Why aren't customers getting post-purchase emails? What am I doing wrong? Marketing automation tech can be both seamless and clunky. In this video, I'm going to show you the four areas to check if contacts are not getting any automated follow-ups. I personally use ActiveCampaign, but if you're using ConvertKit, MailChimp, Infusionsoft, they're all going to be pretty much similar. There is going to be a part at the end that is going to be very much ActiveCampaign specific. I mean, the theories are roughly the same. This is Marketing and Mustangs. I cover everything from online marketing to car stuff, managing ActiveCampaign to Ford Mustang installation. I like to work both on computers, and I also don't mind getting dirty under the hood of a car. If that's kind of your cup of coffee, well, go ahead and do me a favor and hit the subscribe button down below. Now, I'm going to show you the four areas to fix. Let's start with number one. Number one is the email set to draft. Now, what happens is, in ActiveCampaign, if you put an email into an automation, you have to go the entire building process. If you just simply add in the content but then just save and exit without hitting that summary page, it will leave the email on draft, and if this email is on draft, it will not send. So I'm going to right now show you what that actually looks like. I'm going to click right here, I'm going to edit this email. When you're here in the builder, you need to make sure you actually click next. If you do save and exit, this is how it's going to save it as a draft, so I do next. See, the thing is, once you click next and you have a verified from and reply to email, you can go ahead up here and click finish. And as we can see here, it's no longer in draft. It's actually published. Now, number two, it could be that all your emails are published, but for some reason, no one's still getting the email. Here's another kind of simple one. And frankly, I love simple fixes. Is the automation paused? The automation is inactive in ActiveCampaign. ConvertKit, Infusionsoft, MailChimp, they all have their little lingo, but it's the same deal. You need to make sure it is switch to active. Now here's the thing, say if people opted in for a lead magnet and they are going to get this tag or be subscribed to a list, like this example right here. If they subscribe to the list but this was paused, you need to retroactively add these people back in. Just because you switch the automation to live does not mean ActiveCampaign is going to look through all your contacts who are, say, part of this list and add them to the automation. You do have to do that legwork yourself. I like a quick simple fix. Misspellings. This happens more often than you think. Working with clients, I've gotten a fair amount of, "Dane, this contact didn't get an email. There must be a bug somewhere." Sometimes there's a bug, but more often than not, humans are being human. Let me explain. Before I jump to conclusions, I simply search for the contact in ActiveCampaign, sometimes by the first name, last name, whatever email address that the team member gave me. Now, usually if they provide me an email address, I can figure stuff out pretty quickly. For example, if an email address ends in a .com, that's not going to work. If the email is a dimsmail instead of a Gmail, that's not going to work. That means that email is just simply going to bounce. We can't send emails to that contact. So if it is a misspelling, that's pretty easy. All we just have to do is fix the misspelling. Now, if they're supposed to go into an automation, I like to fix the email address and then manually add them into an automation. Sometimes that just happens. No matter how well you build your form, your automation, accidentally hit the wrong key and then pressing enter, well, that can cause a whole heck of a lot of situations. So make sure there's no misspellings in the contact's email address. Number four is actually a pretty important one. And this is going to be a bit more ActiveCampaign specific. Number four, is the contact unsubscribed or on an exclusion list? I hate to say it, but if a customer or a contact does not want to be emailed, they're going to unsubscribe. Yeah, it is kind of not fun, but also unsubscribes happen. Sometimes you just have to let people go. They might opt in for a free training, an opt-in, just to be on your newsletter. Maybe they realize that it wasn't for them. Let them go, and that's okay. Sure, it's annoying, but it is much better to let a person unsubscribe. Now, if they accidentally unsubscribed, or maybe they just plain forgot, in ActiveCampaign, it's pretty easy. You just go to the contact, click the little subscribe part, and done. If they're supposed to have gone to an automation, make sure you re-add them to that automation. That's the good side. The scary side is if they're on the exclusion list. Now, if a contact is on the exclusion list, it can't simply be switched back. Now, how do people end up on the exclusion list? Well, either you manually add them in, they click unsubscribe all from your email, or, and this is not the good one, they mark your email as spam. How rude. When it comes to getting a contact off the exclusion list, the SOP is this. You have to get written consent from that contact, take a screenshot of it, I'm not kidding when I say this, and send that screenshot to ActiveCampaign support so they can remove the contact from the exclusion list to get your emails again. ActiveCampaign, along with all other email service providers, they take spam complaints very seriously. I know this seems kind of ridiculous. I've had to do it myself personally before. At the end of the day, we just need to make sure we're not spamming people. Now, if you want to make sure contacts don't end up on the exclusion list, well, that's a pretty simple fix. Make really good content. Segment your email list. Say if a contact has signed up for a newsletter, make sure that the newsletter they signed up for and the newsletter you're delivering to them are actually the same thing. If they sign up for learning about online marketing and you start spamming them with join my coaching offer, they're probably gonna say, okay, well, that's not really cool. Regularly email your contact email list. Even sometimes I kind of have a hard time this one too. If a person subscribed to a newsletter, say maybe 2 years ago, and you just happen to start emailing them full blast, you're gonna think, was my email address sold off to another company? So I'm gonna mark that as spam. Now in another video, I'm gonna show how to make a self-select form so people can self-segment themselves and you can have the data to actually know what type of contact to make for your newsletter. For example, if a person opts into your newsletter and they wanna know about Facebook ads, there's a real simple way to do that. So I'll be doing that in another video. At the end of the day, to make sure people don't end up unsubscribed or on the exclusion list, it's all about making good content that they want to hear. So to wrap this up, make sure your email is not drafted, make sure your automation is on, make sure there's no misspellings, and of course the last one is to make sure the contact is not unsubscribed or on the exclusion list. If you found this helpful, leave me a comment down below on some other issues you're having with email marketing. And make sure to subscribe to the channel while you're at it. Down in the comments, join my newsletter list. I look forward to seeing you, or at least seeing my camera, next time.